I was going to say, I saw Curtis Sliwa.
Yeah.
He was sitting there. And he comes in with his guardian angel's jacket on, the red beret, and a walkie-talkie. Now, I thought that whole thing had ended years ago.
Mm-hmm.
The whole guardian angels thing.
Yeah.
You know, when Dinkins was in office and it was insane, the city was just rampant with crime. It was kind of, you know, a cool thing to have this vigilante little squad going around. Meanwhile, you know, I don't know what they were doing, but it made the news. And Curtis was always full of pee and vinegar, you know, yelling at the news and yelling at this and saying how the guardian angels are helping the city.
Right.
Now I saw him, and it's something when you see him now, he's like kind of pudgy and old, and he's still got the beret and a walkie-talkie.
Well, in case he has to, you know, go somewhere.
And he did.
To help one of the fine citizens of New York City, Anthony.
During the intermission, he left and had his walkie-talkie and his beret and went outside. Wasn't seen us after that.
Mm.
I guess he had to help out Times Square, especially during op sale. Boy, you just can't find a cop in Times Square, can you? Have you ever seen more police officers in Times Square? I was wondering, what the hell, what does he have to do?
There might have been a mugging on the D train, the 7 train.
Maybe. He had a run out. But I was just saying, it's kind of weird that he's still going around doing that.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't he have a gig? Doesn't he have a job or something?
I think he's doing radio.
I think so.
He's doing it somewhere.
I was just, so, hey, you know. Steve, did you make out with Curtis? No. Unbelievable.
And if he left the play early, how did you get home?
Very funny.